This video explains how to use CRP5 to solve time, speed and distance problems, and we are starting right now. Hello and welcome to Answering ATPL. The focus of this channel is to provide solutions for EASA ATPL questions and other aviation related stuff. Let me know in the comment section below if you are currently taking ATPL theoretical examination. This video is the fifth video of a series of videos explaining the usage of CRP5 computer face. If this is your first time here, consider subscribing to my channel, and click on the bell icon to get notified when I publish a new video. Speed is defined as the distance traveled per unit of time or how fast an object moving. Speed is a scalar quantity, it does not account for direction, while velocity is a vector quantity which is aware of direction. In this video, we will use the terms speed and velocity interchangeably. The relationship between time, speed and distance are illustrated using the triangle on the screen. Where D stands for distance, V stands for speed or velocity, and T stands for time. From this triangle, we can derive three formulas. The first one is speed or velocity. Velocity equals distance over time. The second one is distance. Distance equals speed multiplied by time. And the third one is time. Time equals distance over speed. To use CRP5 as the time, speed, and distance computer, we utilize the 60 index on the inner scale. Throughout this video, I will use the white line, as shown on the screen, to represent CRP5 inner and outer scale. Below the line represents the inner scale and, above the line represents the outer scale. If we were given distance and speed, we could calculate the time taken to travel that distance by setting the 60 index on the inner scale, against the speed on the outer scale, locate the distance on the outer scale. Then, read the elapsed time on the inner scale against the distance. For example, how long will it take, traveling at ground speed of 120 knots, to cover a distance of 90 nautical miles? First we will get the approximation of the answer. 120 knots mean, we travel 120 nautical miles in an hour. Thus, to travel 90 nautical miles, we need a little less than an hour. The second step, we use CRP5 to get the answer. Set the 60 index on the inner scale against speed 120 knots. Align the cursor with 90 on the outer scale. 90 represent the distance. Now, we can read the answer on the inner scale against 90. 45 minutes. You notice the white inner scale is graduated in minutes for distance and time calculations, while the inner orange scale is graduated in minutes and hours. Let now see how the inner orange scale is used to calculate leg time over 1 hour. For example, what is the duration of a flight of 127 nautical miles at a ground speed of 95 knots? First step, approximation. 95 knots mean 95 nautical miles in an hour. Thus, to travel 127 nautical miles, we will take between 1 and 2 hours to cover the distance. Now, set the inner 60 index mark against 95 on the outer scale. And then, position the cursor against 127 on the outer scale. Read off the duration of the flight on the inner scale. 80 minutes, or 1 hour and 20 minutes. Given distance traveled, and elapsed time, we can find the speed using CRP5. To find our speed over a given distance, set the elapsed time on the inner scale against the distance on the outer scale. Then, read off the speed on the outer scale against the 60 index on the inner scale. Let's take a look at an example. We have traveled a distance of 145 nautical miles in 68 minutes, what is our average ground speed? For approximation, we can get a ballpark idea of the answer by saying that as our elapsed time is just more than an hour, our speed will be just less than 145 knots. Next, we will use CRP5 to get the answer. Align the cursor with 145 on the outer scale. Align 68 on the inner scale with the cursor. Next, align the cursor with the 60 index on the inner scale. Now read the average ground speed on the outer scale opposite to 60 index on the inner scale. 128 knots. If we were given elapsed time and speed, we can calculate the distance traveled. To find the distance traveled, set the speed on the outer scale against the 60 index on the inner scale. Then, read off the distance traveled on the outer scale against the elapsed time on the inner scale. For example, the ground speed is 87 knots and the elapsed time is 29 minutes. What is the distance traveled? Our first step, as usual, is to approximate the answer. 29 minutes is approximately half an hour. With a speed of 87 knots, our answer should be slightly less than half of 87 nautical miles. Next, we will use CRP5 to get the answer. First, align the cursor with 87 on the outer scale. Next, align the 60 index on the inner scale with the cursor. Next, align the cursor with 29 on the inner scale. Read the distance traveled on the outer scale opposite to 29 on the inner scale. 42.1 nautical miles. To summarize, for all time, speed and distance problems, the arrangement of the variables on CRP5 is always the same. Speed on the outer scale opposite to the 60 index on the inner scale, and distance on the outer scale against time on the inner scale. In the next video in these videos series, we will discuss on fuel calculations. If you want to learn more about ATPL or aviation, start now by hitting the round subscribe icons. Also, if you have any questions or comments about ATPL or aviation related problems, you can leave them in the comments section. Thank you so much for watching, I'll see you next time.